Hi, AT from CNC at home. I want to try an experiment where I etch on glass and put that on top of a printout to see how that color comes through the glass. I don't know if having the etching on the top of the glass or on the bottom of the glass close to the paper is going to work best. I've done a sample of the car clinic's logo, etched it on a piece of glass, and I'm trying it both with the etching down and in this case the etching on top. Let's go over to LightBurn and see how we get this set up. Remember to give this video a thumbs up. The process in LightBurn is relatively easy. We just bring in our image. Once the image is here, I want to flip it over the vertical axis. I want to mirror it, called mirror horizontal. And the reason for this is once I've burned this on the top of the glass, I want to flip it over and have it be the normal orientation. Now that I've flipped this, I'm just going to push it down into the lower left corner. Zoom in on it. This is all I really need to do. I will assign the burn parameters here. So I come down to my glass etch image black and assign that to the layer. We take a look at that. I'm burning at 1400 millimeters per minute at 70% power, using the Jarvis dithering for the image. That's all there is to it. We just need to save this and head over to the laser and start our burn. I still have room on the power setting test that I did to do this burn. So I will first run my frame option. Make sure that I've got a good working area. The laser's already focused for this material. It should be good. As we saw in LightBurn, I am burning this image backwards so that being on top of the glass, when I turn it over, it'll be forwards and the etching will be then right close to the paper. Now we just take this into the garage and clean the paint off. I'm just using lacquer thinner. I pour a light coat onto the paint and then I can just wipe it off with a shop rag. Some parts of this video might look a little clumsy as I'm trying to do this and record at the same time without blocking what I'm doing. Too much thinking, apparently. Black paint cleans off very easily with the lacquer thinner, and so it doesn't take long to get this entire piece of glass cleaned up. We can see that the etch turned out pretty well. Let me tip this up and zoom in on it, get a closer look. Let's take this back in and set it on the paper printout. When I took this into LightBurn, I made sure to set my burn image the same size as I sent to my printer to print this out. So they are virtually the same size, so when they set on top of each other, they'll be all lined up. This looks pretty good with the etching part down close to the paper or on the bottom. The top of the glass is nice and smooth. Let's try flipping this over and take a look at what it looks like with the etching then on top, further away from the paper. Yep, that's the etching on top there. You can feel it. Doesn't look a whole lot different. I think I like this better with the etching down close to the paper. This process seems to work pretty well. Remember to like and subscribe to this video and enjoy doing your CNC at home projects.